What is Alzheimer's disease?
An illustration of a brain appears while text boxes read, memory, thinking, judgment, and ability to perform daily tasks. As the text in the boxes is read, the brain illustration begins to shrink and lose its color.
Alzheimer's disease is a brain disorder that slowly destroys a person's ability to remember things, think clearly, use good judgment, and eventually carry out daily tasks. It is a common type of dementia.
Text reads, what causes Alzheimer's disease?
Scientists are still working to understand what causes Alzheimer's disease. Research suggests the following may play a role. Age-related changes in the brain, including shrinking of certain areas, inflammation, damage to blood vessels, and changes to how energy is produced in brain cells. Gene variations, which are passed along from family members, a person's environment and lifestyle, and some health conditions, such as high blood pressure.
Text reads, what are the signs and symptoms of Alzheimer's disease? Text reads, early stage symptoms. A woman in her 70s sits at her kitchen table. She is looking at a number of bills that say past due and final notice. The woman picks up one of the bills, then looks confused.
Alzheimer's symptoms vary from person to person and change as the disease worsens over time. People in the early stages of the disease may find it hard to remember things, ask the same questions repeatedly, have trouble paying bills and working with numbers, get lost on familiar routes, or lose things or put them in odd places.
Text reads, middle stage symptoms. A man in his 80s is sitting on the couch in his living room. He picks up a framed family photo that shows his family members. A thought bubble appears that includes the family members and question marks. The man looks confused.
As the disease worsens, people with Alzheimer's may forget how to do daily tasks, such as brushing their teeth or combing their hair, have trouble recognizing family and friends, and experience emotional outbursts.
Text reads, late-stage symptoms. A woman in her 70s is at home in bed. Her son sits at her bedside reading to her. She does not look at him, but looks out the window.
In the later stages of Alzheimer's, the person will become completely dependent on others for care. They may be in bed all or most of the time, become unable to communicate, and have no awareness of recent experiences or surroundings.
Text reads, how is Alzheimer's disease diagnosed? A doctor is speaking with an older woman and her husband in an exam room. The woman is in an exam gown, about to get an MRI brain scan.
If memory problems are getting in the way of your normal routine, it's time to see a doctor. Identifying the disease early on will provide you and your family with more time to plan for your treatment and care. To diagnose a person with Alzheimer's, a doctor may ask questions about health and family history, conduct memory and thinking tests, perform a physical exam and laboratory tests, and refer the person to a doctor who specializes in brain conditions called a neurologist for brain scans or spinal fluid tests.
A neurologist views brain scan images of the woman on a computer. The primary doctor and specialist look at the images together and point out different features of the scans.
These tests can help a doctor make a diagnosis by ruling out other possible causes of memory problems, which may include certain medicines, mental health issues, head injuries, or other medical problems.
Text reads, how is Alzheimer's disease treated? An older couple walk through an urban park holding hands on a sunny day.
While there is currently no cure for Alzheimer's, medications are available and evolving to help treat the progression of the disease and manage symptoms. Lifestyle changes, such as staying physically active or sticking to a routine, can also help manage the disease.
The couple is now at home and sitting at a table eating breakfast. The woman is reading from a tablet computer, which she hands to the man. The screen reads, Alzheimer's Clinical Research. The man scrolls down the page.
People with Alzheimer's, their caregivers, and healthy volunteers can participate in clinical research to help scientists discover new ways to treat and prevent the disease. When you choose to participate in research, you become an important part of scientific discovery. Your contribution may also help your family, community, and future generations lead healthier lives. Participating in research may also help you learn more about your condition and connect with resources such as support groups.
The man swipes up on the tablet, revealing a website address and the logo for NIH, National Institute on Aging.
To learn more about Alzheimer's disease and find resources for Alzheimer's caregivers, visit www.alzheimers.gov.